Let's start off with this $265 billion stimulus program announced by Prime Minister Modi. How does it move the dial for you? We don't know quite, as a previous guest did say, we don't quite know what the contours of it are just yet.
You're right. We don't know what the contours are, what's inside there. But clearly, the way the Prime Minister mentioned yesterday evening, they are trying to cover a very vast canvas of the economy, various types of people, the workers, the laborers, the industry. So I'm very hopeful that from today onwards, we are going to hear some really very encouraging announcements from the finance minister.
So, Doctor, I mean, this was a very bad time for... It's never a good time, of course, for a pandemic to hit any country, but for consumer-centric businesses such as yourself, it couldn't have had a worse time, is it? I mean, how do you see this playing out? What do you see in terms of recovery, and when do you see that occurring? And also, actually, before I even ask that question, how bad is your business at the moment?
You're absolutely right. In terms of timing, the pandemic chose a very bad timing. Our industry, the automotive industry, was already at a very going at a very slow pace for the last 2 years. Of course, it has inflicted all of us. The month of April has seen no production, no sales at all. Having said that, I'm very happy to share that we are already seeing some sparks of light, and we have resumed part production since the 4th of May when the lockdown was lifted partially. Three of our factories are already operational out of the six here in India. The Colombia factory also opened yesterday, day before yesterday on the 11th. We've started to dispatch motorcycle scooters to Ecuador, to Colombia, Bangladesh, Guatemala, and in India, almost close to 40% of our dealerships have opened. We've already sold close to 25,000 motorcycles in these 6 working days so far. So far, so good. Pretty encouraging for me.
How do you see the world having evolved after the COVID-19 pandemic disappears?
To my mind, as we go back to work, we are going into a new world. We are leaving behind the old world. The new normal is here to stay. We will be wearing masks, we will be wearing gloves, and some of us will be wearing hazmats. The people coming back into the factories are already doing that. The world is going to become more digital. It already was digital to some extent. We have already been interacting with our consumers when they are at home. We had a project called Hero Collabs where we asked them to partially design the motorcycle together with us, design merchandise with us, and the response has been excellent. We've had almost 2,500 people sent us designs, and 10,000 people registered. Great response. We've told them how to service their bikes at home. Do it yourselves.
Dr. Munjal, you say so far so good. You've opened 3 out of your 6 factories. When do you expect to be fully operational?
I should say 4 out of the 8. As I said, Colombia factory also is open. The rest of the 3 plants in India are ready to go. We are just waiting for the sales to go bigger, for the sales guys to pull from the factories. And as I said, almost 40% of our dealerships are already open. Now, as we go, every day we are opening more dealerships. I'm personally hopeful that we will be opening all our factories, all our 8 factories, in the next 1 month itself.
What measures need to be implemented for you to remain open?
Right now, what is happening is some of our suppliers are still in the red zone. They are not able to open. If all our suppliers are not open, we are not going to get all the parts coming into us to assemble the motorcycles. Some of them are still in the containment zone. Now, I cannot go out and ask the government to let those factories open in the containment zone. Having said that, since the last couple of months, we already were trying to organize alternate sources, and we have been successful in doing a lot of that. Some of our suppliers in Europe were closed. They have also started to open up now. As we go along, I'm very, very certain and very hopeful that most of our dealerships will also get open over the next 45 days.
Are you hoping for more aid, more help from the government? Would you like to see tax breaks, for instance? What can the government do to help businesses?
As I said in the beginning, we don't know what is there in this stimulus package. Yes, for our industry, the tax is very high. 28% tax on motorcycles, which goes to the common man, is very high. We've been requesting for that to come down. We want free cash to come into the hands of the industry. We want our buyers to get money in their hands. So housing loans, various other loans, etc., moratoriums on loans, interest rates coming down, all of that is definitely required at this time.
Doctor, what would you say is the biggest lesson you've learned during this COVID-19 pandemic?
To my mind, the biggest lesson has been to keep in regular touch with the people, to communicate with them, keep the morale high, spread positivity around you. Now, I have held about 20 town halls in these 50 days with all our stakeholders, starting with the board, our own people in the company, our suppliers, our dealers, our global distributors. We have a lot of expats in our R&D center in Jaipur. I've been talking to them and their families. Great things I've heard from them. They've said they feel much safer here, looked after than they would have back home in Italy or in Spain. We've been building various scenarios during this time. And now, as we go back to work, we are making some of those scenarios work for us.
So, Doctor, I just want to get a sense of also whether, you know, we have stimulus measures around the world. We've, of course, got to India doing that $265 billion that we started with here. But is there always the fear that money being thrown at the problem can often result in many companies which were failing in the first place being propped up and becoming effectively zombie entities?
I suppose when you're trying to help the large set of industries, some of the weaker ones, some of the no good ones will also get help in this case. But what you're doing is you are helping the larger cause, which is definitely the call of the day today.
Dr. Munjal, we're seeing record unemployment in India in excess of 20%. I mean, it's massive. What conversations are you having with the government, and how do you see that impacting the economy?
I'm sure you also have seen that in the previous few weeks, previous few days, some of the state governments have been rejigging their labor laws, which is a very, very welcome step. Now, what also has happened is that a very large part of the workers, the labor in India, comes from the rural markets, rural areas of the country, and they have, unfortunately, many of them have gone back home. To bring them back, into work is going to be a tough task. And I know that some industries utilize a very large number of this workforce. The government is right now helping them go back home, but they don't want to stay. They want to be with their families too. Thankfully, at Hero, majority of our workforce is around our factories, and very few of them have gone back home. We do have the wherewithal to bring them back. As the economy comes back, I'm sure these workers are also going to come back into work. It's going to be very tough for them back home to be able to meet their daily needs, to feed their families.
Dr. Munjal, any acquisition plans? Are you planning to acquire any of your beaten down rivals or any M&A plans overseas?
Well, we are keeping a lookout during this time. And we've anyways been looking out for M&As. In our industry, there have been a lot happening. Some industries are doing very well, some are not doing so well right now. And we are expanding our product lines. We are going into the higher segments of motorcycles where we are not present today. So we've been looking out, and who knows what's going to happen in the near future.